My name is Bruno Sangro, and I'm a hepatologist working in the University of Navarra in Pamplona, Spain. I'm going to talk about immunotherapy of hepatocellular carcinoma. And these are exciting days for immunotherapy of HCC, of this tumor, basically because of the results of what we call immune checkpoint inhibitors. These are molecules that are able to restore and enhance the activity of lymphocytes that are able to attack tumor cells and kill them in an effective way. Around 3 to 4 years ago, we learned that some of these agents called PD-L or PD-1 inhibitors were able to produce around 15 to 20% of objective remissions in patients with fairly advanced tumors after the standard of care sorafenib. When this possibility was tested in randomized trial, the superiority was there, but the trial was formally negative because it did not meet this pre-specified threshold for activity. But nevertheless, what we've learned is that some of the patients show these very deep, intense, durable, and sometimes long-lasting after the treatment is withdrawn, responses that lead to a very prolonged survival. So afterwards, another agent of the same class was tested in an earlier setting compared to sorafenib. And again, the primary endpoint that was overall survival was better, but not to the extent to which the trial could be called positive. And this was formally a negative trial. Although the balance between activity and good tolerability was in favor of nivolumab. With two negative trials, nevertheless, it was very clear, even before that negative trials were in the public domain, that probably, because only a fraction of the patients respond to single agent immunotherapy, that there was a need to combine two other therapies. One possibility was to combine two different immunotherapies altogether. And we had demonstrated quite some time ago that hepatocellular carcinoma is sensitive to another checkpoint inhibition agent, those that target CTLA-4, a different molecule. So now we know that the combination of agents that block CTLA-4 and PD-1 or PD-L1 increases the response rate to 30%. And in some instances, it takes this median overall survival in advanced setting post-sorafenib to almost 2 years, which is a totally unprecedented number. But even more importantly, we very recently learned that by combining anti-PD-L1 agent with the anti-angiogenic and also immune modulatory agent bevacizumab, and comparing that to sorafenib, the combination of immunotherapy and VEGF inhibitors resulted in a very statistically significant and clinically meaningful superiority. That will certainly change the way we treat hepatocellular carcinoma in the very next future.